Hello everyone, welcome to the screencast for an introduction to the Systrom Analysis Pipeline for Transcriptional Regulation Research. The Systrom Analysis Pipeline is developed and maintained by the X. Shirley Liu Lab from the Department of Biostatistics and Computational Biology and Center for Functional Cancer Epigenetics at Dana-Farber Cancer Institute and Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health. The Systrom refers to the set of cis-acting targets of a trans-acting factor on a genome-wide scale, also known as the in vivo genome-wide location of transcription factor binding sites or histone modifications. Chromatin immunoprecipitation combined with next-generation sequencing, or ChIP-seq, can be used to study the Systrom. Systrom Analysis Pipeline, or Systrom AP, is built for conducting integrative analysis of ChIP-seq and gene expression profiling data to help experimental biologists for the study of transcriptional regulation. A variety of transcription factors and histone marks have distinct distributions in the genome. In the ChIP-seq experiment, one can profile the genomic distribution of one protein factor at a time. The typical steps include to cross-link the protein with the DNA they interact, to chop the DNA by sonication or microcorconucleus digestion, then to use an antibody that is specific to the protein factor to pull down the DNA fragments. After DNA purification, PCR amplification, high-throughput sequencing, and sequence alignment, one can get the sequence reads that label the genomic locations of the chipped factor. Using Systrom AP, one can process the ChIP-seq data and perform integrative analysis for functional studies. The functions of Systrom AP can be divided into three categories: data preprocessing, gene expression analysis, and integrative analysis. A typical workflow using Systrom AP is to upload the datasets, preprocess them using peak calling tools to generate peak locations and signal profiles, upload gene expression data to produce specific gene lists, and then use various integrative analysis tools to generate figures and reports. Now let's take a look at what the Systrom AP interface looks like. Simply Google Systrom and go to the first hit for the Systrom website. We can see the Systrom analysis pipeline shown on the top left panel. We also have a few other projects for public data collection, integration, data browsing, and data mining that you are welcome to try. But now let's go to the Systrom Analysis Pipeline website. We can see the Systrom Analysis website. It is built based on the Galaxy framework, and the web interface has three panels. The left panel shows all the available tools, including data uploads, data preprocessing, including Max for ChIP-seq peak calling, and gene expression analysis, and various tools for the integrative analysis. Some other public available tools for next-generation sequencing analysis are also incorporated here for users' convenience. The center panel is the main analysis panel. Let's take the Max2 for example. If we click Max2, the interface has all the places where you can put the input files, and set up all the parameters. When the analysis is done, The center panel is also used to show the results. The right panel shows a list of files stored in the user's working history, including all input and output data files and work logs. If you use Systrom AP in your research, please cite the Systrom paper from Genome Biology in your publications. If you need any help, please join the Systrom Google group by clicking the link on the screen. Have fun with Systrom. Thank you for viewing.